Today's Cont'd teachings, as we continue with our series on parenting. And we continue with our topic which we introduced last time on this discipleship or discipline, on discipline and on elements and issues. And we're able to define discipline elements, biblical discipline and disciple. And we covered part of it, and I want us to pick from where we left and continue. And I want to pick from more principles to remember. One is punishment must fit the crime. There is danger in over punishment and in under punishment. Two, punishment must send a message of how serious the crime was. It must indicate or give a kind of equivalent value whereby the child can rate it. Number three, the level of punishment defines the level of offense that sets a value system. First question parents must ask before correction is, was my child's action the result of childishness or foolishness? The difference between childishness and foolishness is the motive and condition of the heart. Don't thank your child for being obedient. They ought to be obedient. Try to help the child to regain self-control before crossing the bridge of trouble. Time out to regain self-control is before the offense, not after the offense. Until a parent gives instruction, non-rebellious actions remain childishness. Stewardship training should always include explanation on how and why. How and why. Remember, forgetting may be a reason, but never an excuse for failure. Too harsh a punishment exasperates a child. Too lenient a punishment fails to put correct value on the offense. Therefore, behavior which is moral issue, correction of wrong behavior, and encouragement of right behavior. Correction of wrong behavior, namely childishness and foolishness. Childish mistakes is when there is absence of evil heart motives. When there are accidental acts. It is innocent immaturity with innocent motives. These are accidental acts. When childishness is not corrected, the child becomes a wrongdoer. If not corrected, it will bring shame to the mother, as it is said in Proverbs 29, verse 15. Practical correction of childishness. Warning. By telling the child that his actions are unwise and may bring calamity on him or others. Don't be like Eli, who honored his children more than God, in 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 24. A warning should serve as an encouragement to be more responsible. For example, the child forgot to close the garden gate, leaving the dog running outside, or he left his bicycle in the front yard instead of in the garage. If he does not obey, follow by applying related consequences. Related consequences. Some childish mistakes has gone past the warning phase and needs immediate consequences. The consequences must relate to the mistake and be logical. The purpose of the consequences: to encourage good stewardship, to encourage good stewardship, and to get the child to accept the responsibility for his unwise actions. And with property, privileges, and personal responsibilities. Therefore, consequences to property: teaching a child to be a good steward of his own possessions will help him to be responsible with others. Property with others' property. For example, having the privilege of riding on the bicycle automatically comes with a responsibility to care for it. Bicycle gets taken away for a few days. And privileges. Also, privileges need to be handled with responsibility. For example, playing with the rabbits in the courtyard where they cannot disappear. As an instruction attached, the rabbits must be put back in their cage before leaving for other activities. Failing to do so, the child is denied the right to use the courtyard for the purpose, again for a while. Plus, he needs to do the chores of cleaning up the courtyard. Personal responsibility. Even when only accidental at times, children need to take responsibility for affecting other people's property. Choose a job or chore their age can manage to repay and do restitution of the damage, or have them clean up and restore as best as possible. This way, they get an opportunity to understand the value of labor, money, property, and personal responsibilities. Foolishness. There is a presence of evil heart motives. Passive rebellion is indirect defiance and begins with a hidden attitude. For example, pretending not to hear, pleading ignorance to the obvious, replacing obedience by doing good or cute things, instead of constantly saying, "If forgot," and sulking and pouting and whining for things. The acts are intentional, premeditated conception or disobedience. Watch for the quiet child. He seems not to openly defy you, but he has a hidden heart problem and can be the most dangerous one to correctly discipline. They go into a denial and it is difficult to get to know the level they perceive and feel rejected and picked on. They often have unexpected outbursts of anger for no seemingly reason at all. Active rebelliousness is direct and open defiance. Rebellious and wise decisions of the heart. Disobeying, talking back, and refusing to accept correction, rejection of any form of authority. When some types of rebellion is tolerated, child gets mixed signal, resulting in the undermining of character training and taking place. When foolishness is not corrected, the child will become an evil doer. When foolishness is not corrected, a child will become an evil doer. And we need to be careful with what how we see our children and what our children does. It is very, very key. And that is the responsibility God has given us and entrusted in us as parents. Practical correction of foolishness. Consider four factors when deciding on the level of consequences: the frequency of the offense, how old the child is, the context of the moment, the overall characterization of the child's behavior. Consequences. Verbal warning is given for minor offenses. When you need justice, not only need justice, but not punishment. Don't expect perfection when you yourself can only give excellence. When warning need be repeated, then your child no longer falls into the category of minor offenses and needs correction in his behavior. Warning with action is given for borderline cases. Things like old habits coming back, double warnings could be a swap or a rebuke. In general, it is to help the child regain self-control. For example, reflecting timeout, giving the child time to stop doing to think about his actions. A last stop before crossing the line to get into trouble. It is always good to warn. Note, timeout is for before an offense takes place. It is not a substitute for need of chastisement. 2. Consequential punishment is given for routine, open, willful offenses. For example, when your child has been instructed not to fiddle with the television, but tries his luck anyway, since he had an instruction, you may warn him, but if he does not heed to that, he definitely needs consequences. You should not have to repeat a warning, even to a small child of 2 to 4 years old. Had he learned that your instruction is sure and unwavering? The value of your instruction lies in the immediate consequences the child puts to it. A warning, if adhered to previously, may prepare the child to know how to make a wise choice. But at all cost, do not forfeit first-time obedience. The pain is a gift from God, warning us something is wrong and needs attention. The same applies for pain in training a child. It has one purpose, for example, to help a child focus and gain self-control over a certain moral weakness. It is part of the development process, calling serious attention to a condition that dependently needs change or needs changing. Pain comes into two forms: natural consequences due to the outcome of wrong behavior. Use the natural pain as an object lesson. For example, time management lesson: if you are late, you will miss your lift. Do not go back on your word, but your words will then be worthless. Your child needs to know that certain things are exact, like school hours, shopping hours, library hours, and church hours, and many others. Note, only withhold privileges from a child who is characterized by this kind of behavior, and not when he is late once. Colossians 3, chapter 3, verse 21. Fathers, do not provoke or irritate or fret your children, lest they become discouraged and sullen and morose and feel inferior and frustrated. Structured consequences needs to be artificially created to correct wrong behavior. And this happens through chastisement, isolation, logical consequences, loss of privileges, and I want to stop with what I have mentioned, and from here we will begin with where I have just stopped, chastisement, which is packing or hiding to inflict pain to change. We will begin there as we draw to close and as we draw to completion of our training on parenting. I am sure that you are learning something, and I'm looking forward to see and hear from you. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we bless you for your word. The Lord, you are teaching us that discipline is key in the lives of our children. Bless them and be with us this evening. Lord, we thank you for those who listen and who hears your word. And bless them in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you and God bless you.